You can be very intelligent and very good at what you do, and you can still be stupid.
Anyway, yeah, we're back again, annoying people with the truth,
because
a lot of people dislike the truth. Absolutely, of course.
Absolutely.
And we've just had our monthly flat Earth meet.
One thing when you do tell people the truth, and that is they certainly think about it afterwards.
Absolutely. Even though they might not agree with you.
Absolutely.
100%. They'll still go away thinking about it.
Absolutely.
Because I wonder if he was right. Well, he was making a bit of sense there. We did agree with him on there.
Yeah.
There could be some truth in what he's saying.
Oh, and he did actually recognise that I did actually feel uncomfortable. And he did actually... see that and tell me that.
Absolutely. He's never
ever told me that I felt uncomfortable.
No one's ever told me that, because people lie,
because no one's ever cared about me.
Absolutely. No one's ever told me that a lot of people are filled with shit. My parents haven't told me that. My teachers haven't told me.
Could that have been because your parents were full of shit?
Possibly. Yeah I think my parents were filled with bollocks.
Yeah. Some parents, all they care about is themselves.
Absolutely, of course. Yeah. I like it how when you have court cases with kids involved.
Oh, wow.
Always got to think of the child
first. What's best for the child?
What's best for the child? And essentially, when you really do think about it, it's always what's best for the parent, the mother or the father. They couldn't give a shit about what's best for the child.
Absolutely. Because what is best for the child?
What is best for the child? You can't ask the child, well, hey, Tommy, I know you're only 4 years old, but what would you like to do? Would you like to live with your mother or your father? Yeah.
Who's the kindest to you?
Absolutely.
Who loves you the most?
Absolutely. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. The big trouble with this society, and that is children, obviously, because of their age, newborns, and, you know, they're on after, you know, are dependent on adults.
Yeah.
They're dependent on adults who are generally fucked up.
Absolutely.
Now,
yeah.
Children who are dependent upon parents who are generally fucked up haven't got much hope, have they?
No.
No.
Well, from that, one can only draw one conclusion, really.
What's that then, Peter?
The child will grow up to be fucked up.
Absolutely, it's quite likely, more than likely, that the child will grow up to be fucked up as well.
Isn't that what we see in the Globe Society?
Well, we see a lot of fucked up children being brought up by fucked up parents in the Globe Society. Yeah,
only to live fucked up lives.
Absolutely, of course.
And then when they become an adult, then they get with someone and have a child themselves. And then that child leads a fucked up life.
Just like Let This Be the Verse by
Philip Larkin.
Yeah. They fuck you up, your mum and dad. Yeah. Man hands on misery to man. It deepens like a coastal shelf.
Yeah.
It's so easy to understand
life.
The cycles of life.
And it's all about having sex with the right people.
Absolutely. That's what life is all about.
What I found interesting was when I was out at Brook Street Festival.
Oh yes, Peter.
There was a woman coming along and she said, would you like a sexual health goodie bag?
Sexual health goodie bag?
And I said to
her, I bet there wasn't VD in the bag, was there?
And I said to her, the best thing that you can ever do to have great
to
sexual in, health
to have wonderful
is
sexual
to not health. Have sex at all.
Absolutely,
and
of course.
You never guess what I said, Pete.
What was that then, Peter?
Well, I said to her, because it doesn't affect your peace of mind.
Absolutely, of course. And also keeps your willy clean and your vagina too.
She knew exactly what I said. She knew exactly what I meant by that.
Absolutely, yeah, of course.
You have sex with loads of different people, it will play with your peace of mind.
Absolutely, of course.
But nobody tells you that. Not in the Globe Society, because they want you to have a corrupted mind.
Absolutely, just like a lot of people as well. A lot of people, you know, when you think about it, we're living in a society, you know, that, you know, could be an awful lot better.
Absolutely,
yeah, of course. Anyway, we're not here to talk about society and be whatever, but we're just here annoying people with the truth, because that's what we do.
Absolutely. A lot of people dislike the truth.
A lot of people dislike the truth. Anyway. Absolutely. Anyway. But, and how are you, Peter, before
I'm
we get
fine,
going?
Yeah, I'm just come back from the Flat Earth.
Yeah, we've had a very good meeting this
very,
evening.
Very,
it's been wonderful.
Very good, yeah.
We do. I would like to say a special thank you to all of those who turned up and endured our banter or our.
Well,
points of view, our opinions.
It was only for about 2.5 hours the meeting, but it was very packed. We had 6 people turned up, 6 new people turned up, didn't they?
Absolutely, yeah. We had a few people
and
turn up.
The group, they were. I think the 6 people were all in one group, and they were from the Brook Street Festival.
Absolutely.
Inquisitive minds.
Absolutely, yeah. And we've got a new, I believe, we have a new attendee with me and Vic on Saturdays. So
that would be great.
That
would
be great. That's one more person, so that's wonderful. It's nice to know that we can go out there, you know.
Promoting Flat Earth.
Staffed, as it were, you know,
well,
which is great.
Promoting Flat Earth. Cause that's
raising the awareness of Flat Earth, because that's all what we do. That's all what we do. Anyway, now before we get on, let's do our song. Now,
I'm not going to mention what we're going to talk about.
Okay, well, go on then, Peter.
And then we'll say, okay.
Well,
what we're going to talk about today? Because the title of the video, as you can all see,
it's this one here.
It's because there's still people who think
only think in their minds
water is made of hydrogen and oxygen.
Absolutely, yeah. And they only think that because they're told that by the people who also think that.
Absolutely.
But they don't know that.
We've got some more information to drive that nail home. You know, to drive that nail home. To help you unthink that. Because that is completely wrong. How do two gases can exist at room temperature as a liquid? But anyway, what we're going to talk about tonight is we're going to have a look at a couple of comments from some Globies who have left comments on our videos. We're going to have a look at someone making a hydrogen bomb.
Out of water, allegedly.
But we're going to give people a much
A better understanding
what's actually happening.
What's happening in that video?
Yes, and we have a special guest on the show tonight.
Yeah, we've got a special guest. Whoever that is, who's that?
Who's the none other than Bob Lazarr?
Oh, Bob Lazarr.
Bob Lazarr
from the Area 51 fame.
Yeah,
the guy who actually, who allegedly.
Yeah.
Reversed engineered a UFO.
Absolutely.
Woo!
Yes.
Can you believe it?
Yeah, because he's in another guise, actually. And we'll show to people that Bob Lazarr is full of shit.
Absolutely. Bob UFO Lazarr
is full of
filled
shit.
With bollocks.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. But before we get
That's
on.
That's about it, really.
And yeah, we're going to also show a little. We're going to just. We'll show a little image and talk about some of our inverted rust jars.
Oh, well, yeah, because
which is quite interesting.
Absolutely.
But before we get on, let's do our song.
Absolutely.
Now, nobody's given us any requests, or we haven't taken any requests lately. So I thought we'd.
You'll have to put up with one that I've decided to do. Very quickly.
And this is
9 minutes.
This is Neil Diamond and Beautiful Noise.
Oh, I can hear the birds chirping.
I was thinking of the song today.
Isn't that lovely?
I was.
Cars.
Cars, absolutely.
Aeroplanes, cranes, diggers. No.
Beep,
people.
Beep. Beep, beep. Beep, beep. Beep, beep.
Beep, beep.
Here we go. Everybody join in if they want to. What a beautiful noise coming up from the Palm Street. Got a beautiful sound. It's got a beautiful beat. It's a beautiful noise going on everywhere, like a clickety-clack of a train on a track. It's got rhythm to spare. It's a beautiful noise, and it's a sound that I love, and it fits me as well as a hand in a glove. Yes it does, yes it does. What a beautiful noise coming up from the park. It's the sound of the kids, and it plays until dark. It's the song of the cars on their furious flights. And there's even romance in the way that they dance to the beat of the lights. It's a beautiful noise, and it's a sound that I love, and it fits me as well, it makes me feel good, like a hand in a glove. As it does, as it does. What a beautiful noise.
Anyway, here we are. I think we should ditch Neil.
There we go, wait there. Ooh.
There we go. Oh, it went up like a rocket.
Absolutely.
And came back down again.
Anyway, thanks ever so much, Neil Diamond, for with your beautiful noise.
I can understand some people when you say that the Earth's flat. Oh, rockets, yeah, they just go up and then they come back down again.
Absolutely.
It must be, for someone who's young, who watches telly...
For someone to be, absolutely, yeah.
...thinks that this world is this... magical place.
Well, is it somewhere that they can trust? They can put trust in.
They must think. They must find it very difficult to
comprehend. When somebody comes along and tells them that it's all bollocks,
it's all bullshit. Yeah. It's all a show.
It's all pretense. Absolutely. Yeah.
It's your adults. Father Christmas.
Who?
Absolutely. That's all it is.
Who? You know, it's beyond the imagination, really, when you think about it. That we grow up, we go to school, you know, and as we're growing up and going to school and learning about
life. Oh no, you don't learn about life.
Experiencing life, learning about what that we're being told at school and everything. We never actually think to ourselves that all of the stuff that people are telling us, the stuff that our parents are telling us, is all bollocks.
Oh, well, yeah.
It's amazing. We never think that, do we? That it's all bullshit.
Absolutely, yeah.
And people are denying us truthful, useful information that will help us in our own lives.
Mm.
This is the key.
That's right.
And I'm sure lots of people who are listening to this can actually, that would resonate with an awful lot of people.
Absolutely.
Because people aren't taught that in schools within our education.
Yeah.
And a lot of the time our parents, you know, too busy with their lives, their work, their this, their that.
Yeah.
Their bullshit football, their bullshit TV, their bullshit whatever, to tell us what's good for us in our lives. You know,
absolutely, you because know. The only thing that they can say that's good for you
is a job.
Is a job,
absolutely,
and earning some money.
Oh, you've got to get a job when you get older. What are you going to do? You can't stay on the dole. You can't be doing fuck all your time. You've got to be doing something.
Absolutely, and that, when you think about it, is quite pitiful, because really, the top and bottom of it actually is that all people need. It's to find love in their life.
Absolutely, of course. That is it. That's it. I'm afraid, you know, that's the only education that people
need.
Essentially, need.
You mean Brian, Mr. Brian Cox? You mean to tell me that's anyway. All I need to find in my life is love?
Sure.
Absolutely. Anyway, some people might laugh and go,
you mean that's all I need to find in love? Get away. There's more to life than just love.
That ain't going to buy you any food.
But people don't realise that without love, we could all perish.
Absolutely.
We could all perish without it. Absolutely. That's why love is so important.
Oh, absolutely.
People underestimate love.
The power of love.
The power of love. Absolutely. You know, it keeps us alive. Absolutely. What's the point in going to college, going to university?
Having a good job.
Having a good job. Getting loads of money.
Money. Ooh,
and yet you end up committing suicide when you're 30.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that was worth it, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
What's the fucking point of that?
Yeah.
You know.
Mm.
It's ridiculous.
Anyway, let's go on because we've got some interesting stuff to get on with.
We've got some interesting stuff to get on with.
A couple of comments.
I was going to get the thumbnail back up.
Get the thumbnail. Get the thumbnail. Come on.
Now, let's go and start off with, because I'm sure people still think water is hydrogen and oxygen.
Well, they do.
Whereas when you think about it logically, let's just think about it logically. Let's slow down. Okay, relax everyone. Okay. Breathe in. Breathe out. Out. In. Okay.
That's it. Relax. Calm down.
Just think for a moment, okay? Water is a substance on its own. Is a substance
on its own.
On that is water.
It's water. Water.
It's
is
not
water.
Made of hydrogen and it's not made of oxygen.
It's just water.
It's not H2O. It's just water.
Water. Yeah.
When you really do think about it, makes kind of sense really when you think about it. Water has the ability to decompose materials.
Absolutely.
Doesn't it?
Break down
materials. Water. Like steel, for example.
Absolutely.
Iron.
Because it's only the water, the moisture in the air that causes the rust.
Absolutely.
It's not the oxygen.
Absolutely. If you add let's say you add salt to water, the water will break down the salt.
Absolutely, yes.
Absolutely. If you had some paint, for example, the water could break down the paint.
Absolutely.
Because
if
you put a drop of paint in a big, vast tub of water, that paint will soon disappear.
Absolutely. You won't in be the able water. Find it.
You won't be able to find it, will you?
It'll disappear.
Just because it will break it down.
That sounds a bit similar, a similar analogy to the pollution.
To the pollution in the air. Absolutely, of course.
Yeah.
But we're going to continue because we've always, it is our opinion that this is absolutely true. Water is definitely not H2O. True. It's a load of bollocks.
Absolutely.
That thinking is rubbish. Water is water. And we're going to show you some information now that will support our opinion.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, a lot of people think for some stupid
silly reason,
that you can get water, you can get fuel from water.
Water is a fuel.
Water is a fuel. Because people think, they only think because somebody's told them that hydrogen and oxygen make up water.
Absolutely, yeah.
Some people think that you can extract the hydrogen from the water and the oxygen and create a fuel.
Absolutely.
How fucking fucked up is that?
Absolutely.
When you think about it. Now, we've got another video.
Well, we've got another video that demonstrates
how this is absolutely fucked up reasoning.
Well, that demonstrates, that supports that view. But you and I are going to actually show to people what is actually happening.
Absolutely, of course. Now, we did watch this a long, 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 long time ago. HHO generator, so that's hydrogen, oxygen, H2O, generator. Water to fuel converter. Okay. Uploaded by the king of random.
Random.
Well, random.
Anyway, come on.
I'm just going to mute this because we don't need to listen to it. I think what he does is that he just builds this contraption. Okay. And there's the contraption. Okay. He's powered it up as such. And there you go. I'm sure he's using some of... Here you go.
He lights the...
uses electricity. Okay.
From water. There you go.
From water. Poof. Look. Poof. Look at that. Whoopee-do.
King of Random.
King
presents.
Of Random.
Random.
Presents, yeah.
Explore, plot, think, discover.
Mm. Absolutely. Look at all this. Whoopee-do.
Oh, whoopee-do.
Well, I just want to... Random weekend project. Yeah. Yeah. Water fuel generator.
There we go.
Water fuel generator.
There we go.
Okay. We're not going to watch how he's actually made this thing. No. But I think the only interesting part...
But the main purpose of this is to obtain the hydrogen...
He uses electrolysis.
Hydrogen from the water to use as a fuel.
To use as a fuel. Absolutely. But so... So he's getting on. Wait, there, we're nearly there, actually. Yeah. I'm sure we're nearly there.
He uses his contraption.
There you go. So he's got he's getting his
spends most of the time building his contraption.
Look at this. Isn't he good? Doesn't he do well?
Didn't he do well? Oh, Larry. Absolutely.
Now, a lot of science people will look at this and think, now, this is really good science. Look, he's using all his science skills.
Yeah.
His skills of
engineering.
Engineering and all this kind of bullshit to create something that can. It's a fuel. It's a water generator. It's a fuel generator from water,
Yeah.
You know, what, this guy is brilliant.
Yeah, he's fab.
But he's fucked up.
Oh, hold on. Here we go.
Oh, here we go. Look.
Here we go.
This is why the guy's fucked up.
No, well, let's go back. I'm just going to go back.
Yeah, I'm just going to put this back.
Here we go.
Well, listen to this. Listen carefully.
Let it cure. In the meantime, we can ready 6 cups of distilled water and some flakes of potassium hydroxide.
Oh, would you believe it?
Oh, did he say distilled water?
Now, we know distilled water doesn't conduct electricity.
No, it doesn't, does it?
So, how can he split the water from hydrogen and oxygen if water doesn't conduct electricity?
That's a good question, Les.
Yes.
But people would say, these Globies would say, that he needs to add something to the water so that that could happen.
But the water, if he had something to the water, because he did mention potassium hydroxide, didn't
he? Absolutely, yeah, he did, didn't he?
The water will decompose the potassium hydroxide, wouldn't it?
Oh, that's right, yes.
The potassium hydroxide won't decompose the water. That's it doesn't work that way, I'm afraid.
Oh, right, yeah, that's true.
You know.
Because the water still doesn't conduct electricity.
Absolutely.
So it's only the potassium hydroxide
that will conduct the
electricity.
Absolutely.
And therefore, the hydrogen and the oxygen are coming from the potassium
hydroxide. Well, the hydrogen and the oxygen, are coming from the potassium hydroxide.
That's why it's called a hydroxide.
Absolutely, of course.
Yeah.
Do we need to play this?
Well, just play it.
Do I need to...
Just play it.
Okay.
So he's adding...
4 teaspoons of flakes will act as a catalyst to help the electricity flow.
I like it how they say acts as a catalyst. But the thing is, this is where they're fucked
Skewed.
Up. The electricity is the catalyst.
Yeah.
Yeah? Without the electricity, that will speed... Well, the electricity will speed up the reaction.
But the reaction wouldn't happen without the electricity.
Absolutely, yeah, sure. Yeah, I suppose
you're
right,
to have the electricity, but it's the potassium hydroxide that's carrying those ions.
Those ions.
Not the water.
It's got the oxygen ions and it's got the hydrogen ions in it, the potassium hydroxide. Yeah. Not the water.
Absolutely.
The water only facilitates this process.
So when they're stirred in, we can open the generator body and attach a coffee filter to filter the fluid into the super clean casing. The filter is removed and thread tape is added to the...
So even though he's filtering the fluid, there's still potassium hydroxide
ions in the water. You know, it's a fucked up... A fucked up way of thinking. I can't see, after watching so many of these videos, where they're adding something to the water to conduct the electricity. I can't understand why anyone thinks water is hydrogen and oxygen.
Hold on, I was just trying to figure out why...
They need to go and see a psychiatrist.
Why was he actually filtering that?
I really don't know.
Why was he filtering it? I couldn't work out. Why?
Why filter it?
Distilled water is quite...
I can't. Well, it's possible that because he's got quite wide electrode plates, hasn't he?
Possibly, yeah.
So it's
electricity flow. So when they're stirred in, we can open the generator body and attach a coffee filter to filter the fluid into the super cleaned casing. The filter is removed and thread tape is added to the cap, then the generator plates are slowly inserted into the solution and screwed in watertight.
Saving the heat.
To finish up, we can remove the top cap from the bubbler, add some water, and screw it back together.
See, he even used the word solution.
Solution.
He didn't say water.
Yeah, but it's no longer water, it's a solution.
Yeah, and another thing with
The ions would still be in there whether we filtered it or not.
And another thing with this is that if you watch it,
I think
if you watch it when he switches it on, then you'll see the potassium hydroxide.
Come alive.
Oh, sure, yeah. I've taken the sound.
You'll see it. Come alive. Let's see him switch it on.
Wow, what a marvel of engineering.
Oh, look, can you see all that? Now, yeah, you see all the stuff on the
potassium hydroxide.
That's the potassium hydroxide.
Coming alive.
Because the electricity is revitalizing it, you know.
So...
Absolutely. All this is rubbish. It's bullshit.
There we go.
Another video.
So,
water to fuel converter. That should be potassium hydroxide to fuel converter.
Absolutely. Now, can we go on potassium hydroxide and let's have a look at how it's made?
Well, let's have a look at how potassium hydroxide is made.
Because you have to look at how these substances are made
to know what's in them.
What's in them?
Absolutely, Peter. Yeah. Absolutely, now.
Potassium hydroxide. Now, before we read this article, Pete, do you think there's a process of heat that's been applied to the potassium hydroxide?
Let me guess. I'm going to do a bit of foreseeing now.
A bit like an oven or a kiln or something.
Crystal ball? I reckon because if you electrolyze potassium hydroxide, you will get oxygen off at the anode.
That's right.
That means that the potassium hydroxide at some point during its manufacture should have been exposed to heat.
Temperature.
High temperature.
Not direct
burning as such, but
just heat.
So let's have a little read of potassium hydroxide.
Oh, yeah. How is it produced?
Let's have a little look.
Manufacture.
Okay. Here we go. Historically, KOH was made by adding potassium carbonate, potash, to a strong solution of calcium hydroxide, slaked lime, leading to a metathesis reaction which caused calcium carbonate to precipitate, leaving potassium hydroxide in solution. Filtering off the precipitated calcium carbonate and boiling down the solution gives potassium hydroxide, calcinated or caustic potash.
It was the most important method of producing potassium until the late 19th century, when it was largely replaced by the current method of electrolysis
of potassium chloride solutions. The method is analogous to the manufacture of sodium hydroxide. See the chloralkali process.
Oh, right, yeah. So, the heat is applied. Would I be right in saying the heat is applied when it's dried out, when it's to help it drying?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Because in order for... Yeah, absolutely. The potassium hydroxide is it's mainly garnered from the electrolysis
of potassium chloride.
So they put potassium chloride in solution. Add it to water. You've got solution. They electrolyze it. Okay, what you're left with in the solution is potassium hydroxide. Okay, so what they do with that potassium hydroxide is that they heat it up. They heat it up to evaporate the water. But the heat obviously means that the oxygen is allowed to come into the substance.
Absolutely.
That's how they get the oxygen in the potassium hydroxide.
For those people who aren't familiar with our previous videos, our understanding of oxygen is that it's a processed air, and it's mainly processed through heat. Applying heat to a substance will oxygenate that particular substance. Very much like if you put something in a kiln, you're oxygenating it or Calogenating it, as we
absolutely would say. When you think about it logically, if you're manufacturing substances and materials and chemicals, the last thing you want to be doing is leaving it out to just naturally dry out.
Take ages, wouldn't it?
You want to get your stuff out so you get your money.
Absolutely. Yeah.
You'll apply heat to this potassium chloride, potassium hydroxide, in solution to evaporate off all the water. You want to do it. You want to get it out straight away.
That's right. Yeah.
And this is where we think that the oxygen comes from.
But they don't tell you this in this
They don't tell you this in this bit at all. But, hey-ho, you know.
There we go. But that's how... That's where the oxygen comes from.
That's where the oxygen comes from. So essentially what we're saying is that when you electrolyse potassium chloride,
Well, it's through the... chloralkali process,
chloralkali process. Absolutely.
You've got a diagram.
Yeah, we've seen the diagram before, but essentially, when you get
sodium hydroxide.
Yeah, I don't know how to make this diagram bigger. We've been on this before, but when you've got your membrane cell, obviously,
which stops the sodium hydroxide from becoming chlorinated.
Yeah, more or less. Absolutely. Yeah, sure. You've got your NaOH or your KOH coming out here. And obviously, it's in solution. So what they do is they just heat it up.
Yeah, to evaporate.
To evaporate the water. Now, I wonder what temperatures they reach. Because they might reach very high temperatures.
Well, it's got to be over 100 degrees centigrade.
Well, it might actually be 400 degrees centigrade.
It may well be, actually. Yeah.
To evaporate that water off very quickly. Yeah. That's why when we go past all of these chemical plants, there's lots of stacks where there's steam coming off.
Oh, right, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Because they're heating these substances up.
Yeah.
You know,
it's amazing what heat can do, isn't it?
Absolutely. Always remember, and I'm sure we're right on this.
Yeah, we are.
I'm sure we are absolutely right on this. Spot on. Absolutely. So what we're saying to you is that what's in the solution there isn't potassium hydroxide, and even in this chloralkali process with sodium chloride, it's not sodium hydroxide that's in solution at all. It's something else.
What is it?
Well, it can't be hydroxide because it hasn't been oxidized, has it?
Oh, well, can't be. Oh, well, yeah.
Where does the oxygen come from?
Absolutely.
They only tell you that there's oxygen there. It's a hydroxide because they want you thinking that water is made of hydrogen and oxygen.
Oh, right. Oh, that's a good point.
That's why.
But it is
bullshit.
Absolutely, yeah.
Absolutely. If anyone thinks we're wrong,
show us some
evidence. Show us the actual process. Go to a chemical plant yourself and go and see. Go and find out how high a temperature they evaporate the water off.
That would be quite an interesting thing to do. See if you can electrolyse the sodium hydroxide in the chloralkali process.
Yeah.
To see if you can get the oxygen from it. Because... I reckon.
Oh, you won't.
You can't.
Yeah, you can't. Now that is a very good. Now that would be a test. Would prove beyond any doubt.
Yeah.
Whether we're absolutely right on this,
and we could do that. We might be able to do that at home.
Oh, now we might be able to do that. Now that we should do that.
I reckon we should have a think.
We're gonna have a think about that one.
Yeah.
You're shitting your pants, aren't you?
Yeah, all your Globies out
there. All your Globies out there, you're shitting your pants. Because if we can simulate this chloralkali process and we get NaOH allegedly off, okay, and we test that for oxygen, we try and get oxygen from that, and we can't. Because all we've got to do is re-electrolyse...
What's left?
The NaOH that comes out of this.
Yeah.
Come out of this process. Re-electrolyse it without evaporating it or anything like that.
Yeah.
That's all we've got to do.
That's if we can not contaminate it with chlorine.
That's why you have the membrane. So all we've got to do is devise order a kind of membrane to line the tub.
Yeah, we'll have a think about that.
Now, that's a great one. But we love doing this.
It makes sense.
Certainly makes sense, because I reckon this is just our thought, my opinion, obviously. I don't think you'll get it at all.
No, I don't. I don't.
Sorry.
I don't think it conducts electricity at all.
What, the NaOH?
Yeah, I don't.
The alleged sodium hydroxide.
Interesting stuff.
Interesting stuff. Yeah.
Anyway, come on, let's get moving.
Anyway, yeah, I think you deserve a pat on the shoulder for that one. Interesting stuff.
So no potassium. So the hydrogen and oxygen comes from the potassium hydroxide. In their video, in this video, these gases come from the potassium hydroxide that they put into the water.
Which is let's have a little
towards the end.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's after there. Yeah, it's after there. Wait. Oh, it's just after there. Wait, I can use me. Da dee da da da.
There we go.
Yeah, I mean, let's have a look. He's got water.
Potassium hydroxide.
Potassium hydroxide.
Put it in the water.
What's the point of that?
And for those
he's mixing it up, stirring it up. Just getting rid of the large lumps.
Yeah.
What he's doing, why he filtered it, is so that he could get away, he could palm it off as made water.
Made people think
there's water there.
But then why put in the potassium hydroxide?
Absolutely. Why, you know, if there's
he's going to filter it all out.
Absolutely. If there's oxygen, hydrogen in water, well, hold on, why can't somebody just show us it?
Yeah, use the water alone.
Just water, absolutely, yeah.
They can't, can they?
They can't, nobody can do it.
They can't conduct
electricity. It's because there's no hydrogen and oxygen in water.
Absolutely. It's bullshit.
It's bollocks. They only want you to think.
There is.
There is. Yes. Only think up here that there's hydrogen, oxygen in water.
Also remember that the gas that's at the cathode, that the gas that he's lighting in his little video is a potassium based gas.
Will be a potassium based gas. It won't be hydrogen from the water. Absolutely. Because water doesn't contain hydrogen.
And for those who are familiar with our little electrolysis demonstrations, we're going to get another hydroxide that we haven't tried before.
Absolutely, of course, yes.
Because there's something else, but we'll also get a different colour flame with that.
Absolutely, of course, yeah. It's amazing what you can do.
We won't get
with a free mind.
Yeah, we won't get a pale yellow flame. We won't get a brick red flame
from what?
From calcium. Or strontium.
Or strontium. No, we won't get flame.
We won't get a yellow, a bright yellow flame from sodium.
Or a pale yellow from vanadium.
Vanadium, yeah. So. Yeah, that'll be interesting, won't it?
Absolutely, yeah, of course. But
let's get on.
Interesting stuff, nonetheless. So that's that over with.
Potassium hydroxide and how potassium hydroxide is made.
Absolutely, of course, yeah. Because if you need to evaporate water from a substance, you'll apply heat to it.
Yeah, you will, yeah.
To help evaporate, to speed up the process of evaporating the water.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So you're left with a very dry substance.
Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. You'll even kiln dry that substance.
So it's ready to be sold.
So everyone can make money.
Absolutely. And absolutely. It creates jobs as well.
Creates jobs. And people can build kilns.
Cool. Been working down that kiln for 40 absolutely. Years.
Absolutely, of course, yeah. Yes. Anyway.
The state of me.
Absolutely. So anyway, we've done that one.
A couple of...
Now let's have a look at Bob Lazarr.
Oh, wait.
Now, Bobby Lazarr. Now, everybody, who hands up those who haven't heard of Bob Lazarr.
No, yeah, I think most
I think most people have heard of Bob Lazarr. Yeah. Now, Bob Lazarr
is well known for Area 51 and putting out starring in videos about UFOs. And that he's reversed engineered a UFO that was captured
by
the US military.
Yeah, he worked on a UFO reverse engineering.
Now, when you're a flat earther, you know that space is all
bullshit.
Fake.
All fake.
It's all a story.
All story.
So Bob Lazarr and his UFO reverse engineering is all bullshit.
Yeah, but there was a time we were there. We used to think this was really real or it was more than plausible. You know, but now,
I watched a video
Run your car on water. This guy does just that.
And lo and behold, who was appearing on this video?
Well, let's have a little play and find out.
Well, and they run their car on water and hydrogen fuel cells and so on. You're running your car on
hydrogen. Can't run a car on water.
But you're using water.
Right. You use water as the source material. You run electricity through it, mm-hmm. and it breaks it down into hydrogen and oxygen, and then you can burn the hydrogen.
All right, so you found a way to store a lot more hydrogen in hydride. The equivalent of a full tank of gas. You want to fill up your car. How much hydride do you need?
Well, I'll show you.
Absolute bullshit.
Isn't it surprising? He's on this, he's well known for being in UFO shit. Do you know what I mean?
No, yeah.
Reverse engineering, Area 51. And all of a sudden, he's here.
He's here again.
You know, this guy must be paid for bullshit.
He is. All right, I reckon he may have appeared on a Bigfoot video.
Do you reckon he's appeared on Bigfoot? Yeah. Let's get a close-up of him. There we go. There's Bob. He's not wearing his glasses. His big glasses.
Yeah,
because
he wants to look different.
Wait, there was a bit. Wasn't there his name? I'm just going to mute that. There
and
was his name.
And his title. Showed him when he was leaning up against the fence. Yeah.
Oh,
Bob. United.
United Nuclear Corporation. What's all that about? Yeah. Hey?
And even some people left a comment. Isn't that Bob Lazarr out of Area 51?
Absolutely. It's a joke. And the worst thing is, it's a joke. The worst thing is, that's the best thing about being a flat earther, and that is, you know, all this stuff is just bollocks.
And the worst thing is, if you listen to him, he said that you can break down water by running an electrical current through it.
But you can't.
You can't do that because water doesn't conduct electricity. It's only the impurities in the water that will conduct the electricity.
And that break down.
The water will break that down. Yeah. There's so much bullshit information that's coming out that exists in this globe society. Okay. Not my fault.
Not mine.
Not Peter's fault.
No.
You know. Just Bob.
It's just the fantasy. Just the dream.
Just a dream.
It's all
absolutely. But, you know, I'm very surprised to have come out with this documentary.
Well, I was surprised to actually see him there.
Absolutely, yeah.
You know. Anyway.
United Nuclear Corporation.
Does it even exist?
Yes. Absolutely, yeah. Anyway. 1 minute he's on Area 51, apparently, and now he's a nuclear fucking scientist. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's crazy.
You know, talking about something the government doesn't endorse.
Yeah, I know.
You know, it's
rubbish.
Bollocks.
Rubbish.
Anyway, I think we should click him off, don't
you? Absolutely, yeah.
Anyway, there goes Bobby. What have we got now then?
Anyway, we've got a couple of comments.
Yeah, a couple of comments before we wrap it up for today.
Wrap it up.
Absolutely, yeah. Now this is worth thinking about.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, a couple of comments. Now, we had,
Oliver Stiles.
Oliver Stiles, here we go.
Is he in One Direction?
One of the things I would very much like to point out before we go on, and that is on Sunday when I was out and about at the
Brook Street
Music Festival, and on the stall, you know, the Flat Earth, just a Flat Earth group stall, some guy come up to me and he said to me, he seemed very stressed out that we had a presence there, really. I was surprised his hand wasn't trembling like this.
Flower, we don't want you here.
But he said he was so stressed out, he kept bombarding me with questions. One of them was, well, what's under the earth if it's flat?
Oh, yeah.
What's at the edge? What's beyond the edge?
Hold on. Let me get a spade. I'll start digging and let you know in a few years' time.
Think about it logically and rationally. How does he even know that I've been under the earth?
How does he even know, Pete, that there is an underneath
Absolutely. How does he know that I've been to the edge?
How does he know that there is even an edge?
Absolutely. The guy was fucked up.
No, but it just mentally. Goes to show that these people are governed by other people.
Absolutely, yeah.
Their mind is somebody else's.
It's somebody else's, not their own.
Not their own, absolutely, yeah. It's crazy. But why? I couldn't believe. Well, I couldn't understand. Well, I can understand. Okay. It was amazing that this guy came to me with questions that I felt were totally and utterly ridiculous.
Yeah.
Because there's no way I could have gone under the earth. There's no way I can go to the edge.
Well, it's like people saying, "Have you?"
I'm only a mere mortal.
Go to the edge and take a photo, and then we'll believe you.
It's ridiculous. These people are deranged. Okay, they're fucked up.
But do you realise that
they've got problems?
You need permission to go to the edge.
But anyway, but Oliver Stiles. Anyway,
oh, this pilot.
Was this? Oh, this was due to our flat talking. When I was out with Vic, and I ended up talking to a pilot,
or someone who said he was a pilot.
I can imagine he was a young pilot. Wait there, I'm just getting
Cessnas
this is where I'm talking to him. Just at the, I don't really like pointing the camera, in his face, but he's there, he's talking to me, and Oliver Stiles left a comment. He wrote, let's just maximise this. Wait there. Pete, the pilot has not flown high enough to clearly see the curve. I think you knew what he meant. Because the pilot said to me, well, I think I've seen the curve.
Oh, well, I think I'm
thinking, hold on, you should know if you have or you haven't. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're a pilot. Do you know what I mean? Oh, yeah. Well, I think that was a UFO.
No.
Oh, I think that was a cloud. No. But it might not have been.
No, I did see a car drive past me.
Absolutely, yeah, of course.
I think I saw.
We replied, or you did, and you said,
"No, because he's saying the pilot's not flown high enough to clearly see the curve." But aren't ships meant to go over the horizon, 3 miles away?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, come on.
And he's 40,000 feet.
And Oliver Stiles replied, "Yes, and they do."
The guy's not thinking.
So why couldn't the pilot see the curve at 35,000 feet? Absolutely. If it's evident at 6 feet, why not so evident at 35,000 feet? You're typing bollocks, in my opinion. Yeah. I like that. And he had nothing to say.
Yeah, typing bollocks, that's rich.
That's rich, you know. Yeah.
He knows that we've got a point.
We've got a point. It's a valid point.
He knows that he's typing a load of bollocks.
He's typing bullshit. And what was the other one?
Ian Davidson.
Motorcycles.
He's Jim's brother, I think.
Oh, Jim Davidson's brother.
Oh, weren't you going to tell a joke?
Oh, right, yeah. But I might get it wrong. I might muck it up. Let me practice it for next time. Okay. I actually made up my own joke. Ian Davidson, here we go.
There we go, another one.
I think this is the same. Yeah, flat talking on the streets of Chester again. Here we go. Ian Davidson. I don't know which one it was.
And you think water isn't made of hydrogen and
which
oxygen.
One do you want to go from?
And what qualifies you?
Which one do you want to go from?
Oh, I was reading them. Not that one. That one there. You think water
Ian Davidson.
Yeah, you think water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. And what qualifies you to make such a stupid statement? It's very easy
experiment
to do, but of course you think we have been brainwashed.
Think about it. They haven't got an experiment to do will prove that oxygen and hydrogen are in water.
And now I'm waiting for Ian to reply to my comment I left him.
Yeah, okay, go for it.
Ian, firstly explain how two gases can exist at room temperature as a liquid.
As a liquid, yeah. Well, now, we all know that oxygen and hydrogen at room temperature are gases.
Absolutely.
So how is it possible that two gases can exist as a liquid at the same temperature?
Absolutely right.
Okay.
And then I say to him, then you can promote that explanation to the rest of the world, because it would seem nobody knows.
Apart from you. Absolutely, yeah.
Secondly, please produce oxygen and hydrogen from water alone.
Absolutely, yeah.
That is, without adding anything to it.
Absolutely.
I'm sure you have a brain to satisfactorily answer those two requests. If you think oxygen and hydrogen make up water.
Absolutely.
I'll look forward to your comprehensive reply, providing a demonstration I can carry out myself.
Absolutely.
Because I need to verify that what you're telling me
is true.
Is correct.
Absolutely.
and not a load of
it's what's known as independent peer review.
Absolutely.
Not peer review. Oh, I do like that one.
But independent.
Independent peer review.
Or better still, let's take out the word peer and just put independent review. Absolutely. That sounds much better.
Hopefully you might be able to understand that nobody needs qualifications to determine the impossible.
Absolutely.
Because that is just so
And by
true.
The way, we'll dedicate our next video for you, yeah. Which is more or less what we've done, really, yeah. In certain respects.
Yeah.
So, Ian, you're full of shit, mate.
Absolutely.
Unless, of course,
no.
You can prove and provide that hydrogen and oxygen from a bowl of water.
Yeah. But don't put any hydroxide in it, all right?
Don't put anything in it. Get or by yourself.
Or a sulfate.
Don't what I'd suggest,
sulfate in
here
it.
You go, Ian. What I'd suggest. Now, Bob Lazarr, okay?
All right, Bob Lazarr, with Bob Lazarr.
Bob Lazarr has said that electricity will decompose water into its constituent hydrogen parts, hydrogen oxide.
Yeah.
What I'd suggest you, get yourself some deionized water, okay?
Yeah.
Try your hardest to put the electricity through that deionized water and capture the gases,
yeah.
Hydrogen, oxygen,
yeah,
okay,
that's the one.
And then all you got to do is record it and then test, obviously, for your hydrogen, squeaky pop, or just make the poof,
yeah,
and oxygen, glowing splint, it just glows brighter
or relights the glowing splint,
relights, absolutely. All you got to do, so simple,
go on then, off your pop.
Or if you can't do that, then go online, have a little look on the internet where there's lots and lots of information, lots of videos, and see if you can find one. If you find one, just send us a link. Okay.
Cheers, Ian.
Nice one.
Yeah.
Ha!
Yeah.
You won't find one.
You won't find
you
one.
Won't do it because it's do. There's no hydrogen, no oxygen in water.
Absolutely. It's always in the substance that you put in the water.
Absolutely. It's always in the impurity you add to the water.
Absolutely, yeah.
Absolutely, of course. And I think that'll wrap us all up for today.
That will do.
Oh, before we go, we've got to do something. We've done a few.
Oh, right, yeah.
We've done a few. We've done quite a few little demonstrations.
You want that video, percent oxygen.
Oh. Now, we've been on this video before. Let's have a little look. I did have a look at it before.
This video that demonstrates that there's 21% oxygen.
This one here.
In the air. Which you and I both think is a load of
we both think this is bullshit. Now this guy, here we go. We've seen this one before.
Yeah.
But it's worth having a look. This guy puts two inverted test tubes in a pool of water.
Yeah.
One of the test tubes has a saturated amount of wire wool, steel wool, acid.
Yeah, wire wool saturated with vinegar.
With vinegar and water.
Yeah.
Okay. In one of the tubes, and the other tube's empty. Okay, and he's noticed, he's recorded, this guy has recorded.
Recorded
that where the test tube is with the steel wool, the water level has risen.
Yeah.
And he works it out, calculates it to be roughly one fifth of the whole cylinder, the whole tube.
And he says, well, that's the water's displaced the oxygen that was in the air.
The oxygen that was in the air
now
has been absorbed into the wire wall
to cause the rust.
Because they say allegedly that oxygen is required for rust to occur.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, would you get the same amount of displacement if you put half the amount of wire wool in there?
Well, you see, the thing is, he's got wire wool in that test tube. So that's going to take up a certain amount of space.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So he hasn't really got one fifth, really, has he?
Not really, no.
No, he's got less than one fifth. But nevertheless, we're just nitpicking.
Okay.
Because the real matter why we brought this to everyone's attention is that this is definitely bullshit. They are selling you a crock of shit. Because we've always got to remember that people are always trying to find ways to support the idea, that the Earth is a sphere. Yeah.
And there's 21% oxygen in the air.
And there's 21% oxygen in the air.
Yeah.
Okay. And that water is made of hydrogen and oxygen. Only the idea.
Yeah. So
they're getting information. They're doing demonstrations to support ideas. That's all they're doing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. And we also have to remember that oxygen is a processed air.
Oh, oxygen not is processed
part
air.
Of the air.
Not part of the air at all, in our understanding. Standing. Which standing. Makes absolute sense.
Yes.
It really does. But where's the... so, I... not that one. This one.
This one.
Now, yeah. This one here. You'll love this one.
Yeah.
Now, we've had, on our windowsill, we've had a jar.
Well, when we did some electrolysis.
When we did some electrolysis. Yeah, we've got the jar here.
Oh, well, yeah.
This is the jar here.
I think we were doing electrolysis of sodium hydroxide.
Yeah, we've shown this video before. This video here before. This jar is filled with hydrogen.
Well, this...
And it's got moistened wire wool wedged at the top of the jar.
This jar is filled with the cathode gas when electrolyzing sodium hydroxide.
Absolutely, yeah, sure. That's the one. So it's... Yeah. Okay, now we can note the water level there, and the water level there, and the colour of the water as well, which is important.
Yeah, but we can clearly see that the water level in this image has risen.
This water level has risen. Yeah.
But there's no oxygen there.
There's no oxygen there.
How could it have risen?
How could it be? Wasn't the one before due to the oxygen being absorbed by the rust, by the wire wall,
to
help cause the rust?
That's what they said.
Well, why is this happening? There's no oxygen here.
No.
Oh.
Didn't we notice that when we did carbon dioxide as well?
Yeah, we noticed exactly the same when we did carbon dioxide. Absolutely.
Oh.
But one thing we did...
There's obviously no oxygen then.
Absolutely. Something's not quite right then, Peter, is it?
I think someone's telling us a load of shit.
I think somebody's telling us bullshit.
Absolutely.
Absolutely, of course. Yeah. But what we did was that we actually took a photograph of this jar today because it's still inverted.
Yeah, because we left
it. It's still there because we've left it for
quite some time,
a number of weeks.
Yeah, but you can see the green there.
Yeah, you can see green. Yeah, absolutely. Now look at the water colour.
Look at the water colour in there.
We'll look at the water colour. Okay. The colour of this water is only tap water, okay? Yeah. But the colour of this water has gone green.
Mm.
Now we're wondering where on earth has it come from, this green colour?
Cool, yeah. I mean, it could be contaminants. It could be contaminants within the
Well, the carbon dioxide water didn't do it.
No, it didn't do
it. No other water has done it apart from the hydrogen.
Well,
you know what?
You know what, you know what I think, Pete?
And what's that?
Because science is all about doing things repeatedly, I think we would need to do it again.
Just to
see if we get the same results.
Absolutely. Well, we are going to do it again, but we're going to do a slight variation on on the demonstration.
We're not going to tell anyone yet,
but we'll leave that for everyone to find out.
Because we want to see what the outcome is.
Absolutely. But one thing I would like to tell everyone, and that is...
water level's gone up even more, hasn't it?
Absolutely. I noticed. Let's just have a little look at this. Now, can everyone see this little pen mark here?
Oh, I can see that.
Now, the water level at the moment when we took the photo, which was just a few moments ago or before we did this video, the water level was slightly under.
Yeah.
Now, during earlier, it was a lot higher, wasn't it?
I don't know.
I'm sure it was, It was a lot. Oh, sorry. What I should say. I should say is it's been a lot higher.
Is it?
Yeah, it's been up to that blue mark.
Oh wow.
The water level has been up to the blue mark.
Sounds like it goes up and down.
It sounds as if it goes up and down.
Could it be something to do with the temperature?
Absolutely. Now that is a good thing to mention.
Let's have a look at the previous photo.
The previous photo. Let's have a look at the it's on here.
Previous photo.
Yeah, if we look at
we can't really see it there, can we?
But you can, wait there.
No, you can't see the level of the water.
Yeah, there.
Oh, there.
Yeah, you can see the level of the water. I can't maximise it.
No, I'm not sure.
Yeah, there. The water level's there.
Oh, it's a bit lower there.
It looks lower there. But the water level has been fluctuating. Now, we firmly think at the moment that what's happening is that it's the expansion and contraction of the gas that's in the jar, which is causing that water level to rise up. So it's got absolute fuck all to do with oxygen.
Absolutely, yeah.
So when we look at
sorry guys.
So when we look at this demonstration that this guy's doing,
it's just a load of bollocks.
Absolutely. I'm just going to play this from here. When we look at this demonstration this guy's doing, it's all about expansion and contraction of a gas.
Of a gas, yeah.
That's all it is. That's what's causing the water level to rise up.
Yeah.
It's got fuck all to do with oxygen.
Yeah, because the oxygen isn't
absolutely
disappearing into the, isn't being absorbed into the rock.
There you go. You see this go up, but it's down to what did we say?
The contraction of the gas
inside, because it's the temperature.
Yeah, because the temperature inside that test tube is colder than it is outside.
Absolutely. Now we do know that the temperature is slightly colder.
No, if you get some steel wool, anyone can do this. Get some steel wool.
And you get to see the condensation.
And put a thermometer inside it. Take the temperature. Then you get the same steel wool, and then wet it, and then take the temperature. You'll notice
a big drop.
Well, when I did it, I noticed about a five degree temperature difference.
Yeah. That's all you got to do. Get some wire wool. Okay. Get a thermometer. Stick it in the stick the wire wool around the thermometer, and just read how much the temperature is.
Yeah.
And then wet that steel wool. Okay. Wet it. Okay. Mm. Shake off quite a bit of it. Then bung it on the thermometer.
It'll be cold.
And notice the difference.
Absolutely.
It'll be an awful lot colder.
Yeah.
Expansion, contraction of gas. And this is what we think at the moment. And which sounds really, really plausible.
What I might do is I might do that for the next upload. Actually just pop it in.
Oh, right. Sure, yeah. People. But that's one thing. And the other thing is, well, there is another thing to do with this, but we're going to cover that in another video.
All good stuff.
Lots of great stuff to come along over the next coming weeks. And we've got a little experiment that we've got going on at the moment. Demonstration.
Something to do.
Absolutely. And absolutely, yeah, of course. Anyway, thanks ever so much. And always remember, if something doesn't make sense, like oxygen like and
Ian Davison thinking that there's
oxygen. Where did my thing go?
Looking
for me, did you? There we go. Hydrogen and oxygen are in water.
Yeah. Ian Davison thinking hydrogen and oxygen make up water.
Absolutely, yeah. Or, you know, thinking that you need oxygen for rust to occur.
Yeah. And for those who haven't been watching our videos, I feel as if I have to say that, because we are getting some new subscribers, aren't we?
Absolutely, we're getting new. Yeah, hello to new subscribers.
But one thing, and that is, you and I both consider that we people just breathe air.
Absolutely.
We don't breathe oxygen. Oxygen is a processed air.
Absolutely processed air. It's
not in the air.
It's because nobody can actually prove beyond any doubt whatsoever
that oxygen is a constituent part of the air. Yeah.
Nobody can do that.
Absolutely.
So why should you accept it to be true when no one can show you it?
Absolutely.
Doesn't make sense to me.
Absolutely.
It's like if you said to me you've got £5 in your back pocket, am I gonna accept what you're saying is true or not?
Yeah.
I'll take it with a pinch of salt.
That's it.
Now if you showed me it,
that's a different matter.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Of course, yeah. So absolutely. And if you think that Bob Lazarr is truthful.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, really, I think he's paid.
He's got to be a paid, he's a shill.
Yeah, he would be a shill. Yeah.
He would be a paid shill.
Yeah.
Bob Lazarr.
To put
Stanley, Stan Meyer as well.
Yeah, even I.
Stan Meyer, paid shill. Bugging out all this bullshit.
Well, when you think about it, you know, there's people who talk about false flag operations.
Oh, right.
And all actors.
They're all actors.
So Bob Lazarr is no different.
Absolutely. You can have a false flag operation like what Bob Lazarr does.
Yeah, basically. Yeah.
So I went down to Area 51 and I did some reverse engineering. Yeah, we got on board a plane, no one talked to us, but then I had an interview with this guy. He had wore sunglasses, wore a dark suit, of course. And he was fucking really hard on me, Do you know what to do? So I pissed my pants. Yeah. After I dried up my pants and everything, I got up and I went out to see this UFO and fucking hell. And then he pooped my pants then.
Should have fucking seen the size of it.
Absolutely, I didn't know what to do. Yeah, and then I saw this green little alien come up and he went up to me, and he said, "All right, is your name Bob?" And he went, "Yeah," I says, "Yeah, my name's Bob. What's your name then?" Do you know what I mean? It's all bullshit. It's all absolute rubbish.
Rubbish.
You know, it's rubbish.
And it's just, it's so laughable. Yeah, I know, it's so laughable, the amount of people
that fall for it.
Fall for it all.
Absolutely, of course. It's crazy. Anyway, so that's it. So thanks ever so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye. Ciao.
The earth isn't round, it's flat.
How do you know?
I've observed it in all my travels over Europe. It's flat everywhere. It's